Hi, in this video we're going to learn how to work with the Media Manager. First we have to sign into the website. And once we are there, we must find the link to the Media Manager page. Now, let us quickly discuss what would the Media Manager be used for. Well, firstly, it is used to create folders on the web server to hold our images and our files. It is used, of course, to upload the images and the files to the web server, and it is also used to remove old and unused images and files from the web server. Why do we want to upload images and files to the web server? Well, images and files are used in the gallery. Images are also used in articles. Files are used for download by members and the public, for instance, application forms. Next, let's have a look and see how we can navigate through files and folders in our Media Manager. Here, you will notice we have a few folders. To go into a folder, just click on the folder or the folder name, which will then take you down into that folder. Note the current folder indicator showed that we were in the top level and we have now navigated down into sample data. In the sample data folder, we have two subfolders. We can of course click on the Parks folder to navigate further down into our folder. Note on the current folder indicator, we came from the top level, went down into the sample data folder, and then went down into the Parks folder. Underneath the Parks folder, we have two further subfolders called Animals and Landscape, and we have two files. Of course, if we want to go back to the sample data folder, in other words, one level up, then we simply could click on that little green arrowhead that points up, and as you can see in the pop-out go up one level. Or we could click on the link that says sample data. Let's use the arrowhead. As you can see, we're now back into the sample data folder. Going down into the Fruit Shop folder. If we go down in the Fruit Shop folder, we will see that we came from the top level down to the sample data, down into the Fruit Shop folder. And in the Fruit Shop folder, we find four files, no further subfolders to go down into. And of course, if we wanted to find a quick way to go back to the top level, all we have to do is click on the link that reads top level. Right, so next let's have a look how we can create folders. You will notice down here we have what we call the folder and file upload box. There, in that input field, we can create new folders if we wish to. Before we create a folder, of course, we have to decide where we want that folder to be. It may be in the top level, or it may be under any one of these folders. If we go down to, let's say, the image folder, and we create a new folder there, then that new folder would be a subfolder of the image folder. Let's let's assume we're simply going to call this folder subfolder 1. A word on naming. Of course, names, if we use names, they should be descriptive so that we know what types of files we may find inside of them or images. And of course, a second point is we should always avoid using spaces like that in any names that we use, whether they be folder names or file names. Sometimes when you use spaces, it may cause problems with websites. So we can simply remove the spaces, and we can still see by the use of capitalization that we are talking about subfolder 1. Of course, if we do want to have a space, we can always use hyphens, like so. Or, more commonly, people use underscores, which indicate that there should really be a space. I like to use no spaces and use capitals to show the beginning of a new word. All we now have to do to create a subfolder under the folder image folder is to click on the add a new folder icon on the right hand side of the input field, and then you will see that in the image folder we now created a subfolder. If we click on subfolder, of course there are no files, it is empty. Going back to the top level, in the top level, of course, we can't see our folder name because it is a subfolder of image folder. If we wanted to create a folder on the top level, then we simply have to do it here. Let's call that Holiday 2015. Of course, again, spaces is a no-no, so I will simply remove the space. I could have typed it without the space in the first place. Clicking on the Add a New Folder icon will add the new folder in the top level. And there you have it. Let's have a look and see how we go about uploading a new file. First thing we have to do, of course, is to navigate to the folder in which we want to add our image. Open the folder. Now that we have it open, all we do now is to click on the Choose File button, which will open up our Windows Explorer. In the Windows Explorer, of course, you can now navigate to the folder which contains the images you want to upload. And all you have to do now is to simply select the image you want to upload, click on the Open button. It will put the image, the file name, into the input box for us. If we now click on the Upload a New File icon, it will upload the file successfully into the Holiday 2015 folder. How can we rename a file? If we want to rename that to a proper descriptive name, then we can use the Rename File icon to the right of the image, which opens the file name into an editor field for us. And all we can now do is put the file name, choose a new file name. I will call this file a ship because spaces aren't allowed. I will remove the space. So to activate the change we've made, we have to click on the little green tick icon to rename the file. And there, the file is now renamed. Let us move back to the top level. Of course, if you can rename a file name, you may also be able to rename a folder name. For instance, if I go down to the image folder and I decide that subfolder 1 is not descriptive enough, I may click on the rename folder icon, which will do exactly the same, will open the name inside an editor field for me, and I may rename it to my images or any other descriptive name I should choose. To activate my change, I click again on the green tick icon to rename my folder, and the folder has been renamed. Now, let us assume that we are now in the next year and we want to remove files that we know are not used anymore. How do we go about that? Well, simply identify the file that you don't want to see anymore and click on the red X icon that reads remove file. When I click on the icon, I am presented with a information message that says you are about to delete that file from the repository. Are you sure you wish to proceed? If you wish to proceed, click on the OK button. If you want to keep the file and not delete it, then click on the cancel button. In this case, we really don't need that file, so we're going to click on OK, and you will see that the file has been removed. One note, as you can see, folders cannot be deleted because you do not have a delete icon for it. How can we reorder or sort our files into different sequences? Let us have a look. If I go to a place where we will find some files, there we are. You will notice that we have a handful of files, 8 files to be precise, that may be sorted in any sequence we want. That little arrowhead indicates that currently the files are sorted by file name and it is set in ascending order. You can see 120 goes before 180, goes before 250, etc. You can change the sort order into a descending order if you click on the file name again, or even on the icon, and you will see that the files are now put into descending order. It is also possible to sort files by their size. If I click on there, I will then sort the files into a descending size sequence. As you can see, 15, 10, 10, 8, etc. If I click on that again, it will then sort it into ascending order for me. It is also possible to change files by date in date sequence, last changed date sequence. Unfortunately, as you can see, these files are all the same date. Let's see if we can find files that aren't in the same date. Let's go into headers. And yes, there you can see our files for 2016, 2015. So at least there's one file that can show us that the sequence will change. If I click on last change, it will order this in descending order. The newest date is on top and the oldest date on the bottom. If we click on it again, then you will notice that the oldest file will be on top, so this will be an ascending sequence. Note that that arrowhead points up, or if you click, points down to show you the order in which it has been ordered. Well, that is all we can say about Media Manager. One last thing we can mention is that, of course, as you've seen, there's an icon that means that you could close this folder and file upload box if you wish to do so. Of course, when you start this up and it is not shown, then simply click on the plus sign to open up the file and folder upload box. That is all for this video. To close this page, simply navigate to any other page and your work is done. Of course, when you are finished with all the work that you want to do on the web page, then simply click on the logout button and you will log out of the administration layer of the website. Thank you for watching.